So we're doing HAG again. But it's not the type of, it's not the build that you guys think it is. It's a new build. It's called the BODYBLOCKER HAG. And this build is goddamn deadly. I love it. I'm loving the new change that they did to HAG and Trapper. We're gonna do another Trapper build soon. Don't you worry. Vaultmaster Myers is coming too, so don't you worry. Vaultmaster God. But if you don't know what BODYBLOCKER HAG is, it uses Scarred Hand and the Waterlogged Shoe in order to body block people from using pallets and doing certain things. It's actually an amazing build, so I recommend you try it. But what we got here is we got Tinker, so when a generator is repaired to 85%, my terror radius goes down to zero and I get a notification. The terror radius goes down to zero for 12 seconds. Then we got Monitor and Abuse, so it's like really good on HAG since their terror radius is 24 meters, so it reduces my terror radius out of a chase by 8 meters and increases it while in a chase by 8 meters. Then we got Hex Ruin, slow the game down just a little bit, and also it's really good when I can body block my totem so they can't get to it. And then Save the Best for Last, so this is a new Save the Best for Last. Each token grants a stackable bonus of 5% for a successful attack cooldown. And I can earn up to 8 tokens, but when I smack my obsession, I lose 2 tokens. When I smack anyone else that isn't my obsession, I gain 1 token. And then for add-ons, we got Scarred Hand, so my phantasms have collision, and even the trap itself, without even triggering the trap, has collision. And then I get extra blood points of deviousness, but I can't teleport to my traps. And this is the thing about this. So, what we got is Waterlogged Shoe, so when they trip a trap, they get the hindered effect when they're in the vicinity of the triggered trap, and then increases my movement speed slightly, and I can't teleport the traps. And then, for offerings, we're gonna go to the game, because I played this on the game once, and oh my god, it was deadly. So I'm just loving it. I have to do it again. So, we're gonna see how well BODYBLOCKER HAG does to these potatoes. So right off the bat, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna trap choke points and things like that, pallets, so that they can't get past. And the best thing about this is even while you're in a chase, you can still place down your trap. So if they're looping something, you just go like this, place down your trap, keep chasing them around. He won't really expect you to have a Scarred Hand right off the bat, which is the good thing. So you can go ahead, just place all your traps at choke points and pallets. I saw where they were. And make sure to place it inside the pallet so they can't get to it from either side. So both sides of the pallet is going to be trapped just with that one trap. I was waiting for that. So we got 2 stacks on our Save the Best for Last. We're gonna try not to go after the Claudette. I was so hoping that wasn't gonna break so fast. We're gonna try not to go after the Claudette, which is our obsession. I'm gonna try and save her for as long as we can. Oh, he got through it. What the hell? Oh, it's because I'm pretty sure it's because I hit him too. This is the obsession. I didn't want to go after him, but he has object of obsession. I'm going to see if I can do something about it. So it blocked him in. Forced him back this way. Oh, come on. That just had to be closed off, didn't it? I should have broken this. So I have that pallet trapped off, you can't use it. I already wasted my save the best for last by hitting him once. I'm gonna see if I can get rid of this decisive. Oh, he doesn't have it. He has object of obsession only. That makes it even better. But what we don't want to do is go killing him just yet. But what I will do is go and trap these two again. He's right there. Oh, come on. Alright, so we got him. He's healing inside there, so that's okay. So I got a lot of map pressure right now. All right then. He's above me healing. We're gonna go ahead and kill this guy quick. Then go back and pick him up. He decided to quit, okay. So we still have 5 tokens on our save the best for last, which is nice. I was really hoping my rune wasn't gonna break that fast, but they found it way too fast. I gotta start trapping shit up. He thought it was going back, but I wasn't going back. So we're also getting rid of a lot of pallets too, which is nice. So now I can go ahead and do this. They're getting that generator. Should be pretty close to 85. Got rid of the 2 god pallets. So I'm gonna lose another 2 stacks here, which kind of sucks, but it's okay. Alright, it did its fucking job this time! What we're gonna do is we're gonna try to keep him in the basement now. We're gonna try and get him dead so that I can gain some more tokens at the same time as keep my tokens. Come on, place it. There you go. We're gonna keep him in the basement. He's just giving up. There was no way they were gonna win. Right when I had that many stacks and he was gonna die, there was no way they were gonna win. It was inevitable. So where did he go? And that's the end of the game. Literally, that's the end of the game map. So all it does is when it's supposed to work, is it basically blocks them. You can also take away logged or waterlogged shoe and use the one that increases either the trip distance of the phantasm or the trip time that the phantasm stays up. You can use both of those add-ons also instead of the waterlogged shoe. But I like the waterlogged shoe and the scarred hand. They're really good add-ons now. So we're gonna try this again, and maybe it won't allow them to walk through my phantasms sometimes, which is kind of annoying. Cause it's supposed to be blocking, you know, like what the ability's supposed to be doing, blocking them. But for some reason, it allows them to hop through. All right, where's my totem? My totem's up there. We'll go to my totem while setting down some traps on the way, since the trap time is so nice now. Love it. All right, so what we're gonna do, gonna trap right at the top of the stairs. There's two boxes that got brought into the game. They're definitely inside the washroom. But I gotta make sure I place these traps. And I gotta make sure I place traps while I have time. Urban immersion. All right, so we got one obsession. He's the David, if I remember correctly. We should be able to catch him here if it blocks him. Very nice indeed. We got one guy here. This is the David. I don't want him because he's the obsession. Alright, got the Claudette. David's taking his sweet ass time. Alright then. Oh my god. That was Blagna. Go away, David, I don't want you. I'm not stupid. All right. Go ahead and smack this guy. Get him away from me. Then we'll go ahead, pick him up, bring him to the basement. We got a lot of pressure on the map so far. We're doing really good. They're popping all my traps. I'm gonna go ahead and kick this generator because I want to keep this generator. It's in a nice spot. I gotta replace some traps. I just heard someone drop down. Yep. He's going to save. Oh, nope, he's still here. David's gonna go save right now. Do I have a trap here? No, I do not. I'm pretty sure he's disconnecting. Because he's not doing anything. Yeah, he disconnected. Oh man! This build gets people salty. Oh man, this build gets people salty! Alright, David, get your ass back here. Let's end this quick. Don't make it any harder than it has to be. Woo! That was a good one. I like that one. You ain't gonna get it with me again. I knew you had dead hard. You're a David. I knew you had dead hard. I might have to do another one. Cause literally, they all just rage quit. This build, just Scarred Hand in general, is gonna start getting a lot of people rage quitting. I don't know why. It's really not hard to play around. Once you see CS Guard Hand once, it's really not hard to play around. Real shit. I'm just all about this money. I don't think about no thighs. No thighs. Girl, you don't know about me, so get off my fucking D. Born and raised in the thigh. This is real as you gon' see. Girl, you don't know about me, so get off my fucking D.